Hello friend, welcome to my channel 5 Minute Pediatric. Few days back I have posted a picture on Facebook, the picture of this newborn baby who comes to us with this multiple pustules. Okay, so the diagnosis, the baby was healthy, active and accepting feed well. So the diagnosis was transient. Okay, then next, neonatal pustular melanosis. So I will split all the term and you will learn at least 4 to 5 points regarding transient neonatal pustular melanosis. So the word transient, so this condition is for short period, okay, as it is transient. Okay, let's discuss first. It is in neonatal, that is present at birth, okay, and pustule. Okay, the child is having pustule is superficial, flaccid, and if we look, that is without erythema. If we go for scraping and go for peripheral smear, shows neutrophil in scraping. Okay, and we have it is for short period, that is transient, and usually resolve in 2 to 3 days. It's a self-limiting condition, but when it resolve, it leaves hyperpigmented macules which slowly disappear around 3 weeks to 3 months. So if a baby comes to you with this type of lesion, always suspect this benign condition, transient neonatal pustular melanosis, if the baby is healthy looking, healthy baby is active. And if you have any doubt, go for sepsis profile, because we have to rule out sepsis also in this condition. Okay, other condition we have what we called the closed differential that appear on day 2, that is erythema toxicum. Okay, so in this condition also baby is active and playful, and the baby has erythema. Here also baby has erythema that present over face, over trunk and limb. Okay, and if we go for a scraping, here we get eosinophil. Okay, this also disappear quickly. So these are the transient condition and they easily disappear. So you do not have to worry. You have to assure mother that the condition is benign. I have made video on erythema toxicum versus staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome. You can go to my channel and watch, because these are the common neonatal skin manifestation and you have to know all these. Okay, hope so enjoyed this video. Kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel. Thanks for watching. Okay, this is the disclaimer. So you have to know the closed differential, erythema toxicum, and SSS, that is staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome. Here in these two conditions, you can also differentiate. Nikolsky sign is positive in scarlet skin syndrome. Okay, and here it is negative. These two conditions are transient. Okay, hope so enjoyed this video. Kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel. Thanks for watching.